Hi, I'm Uday Kukaria and I'm the creator of Formsify. So what Formsify is? Formsify helps you in creating better forms which are decentralized, trustless and distributed. Let me give you a quick about of the set of Formsify. First one is the problem. Like what are the problems which we are currently facing? That the online survey services they are currently which are available are centralized, trust-based and dependent. Thus we have problems of integrity, transparency and accessibility. How these are the problems? Let's have a discussion about it. Integrity. Like, how do you make sure that the server which is actually holding your information, it wouldn't be compromised in the future, or the platform wouldn't go down which is holding your form, or the system wouldn't betray you which is holding your data, right? Second one is transparency. Like, how do you confirm that your data was unaltered, that no one actually tampered with it, or your forms, they were actually fair to all the respondent, or no one filled forms on behalf of others, which is actually happening in today's world, right? The third point is the accessibility factor, that how do you ensure that your data would be accessible even when the system goes down? Like suppose someone decides to run away or there is much traffic, like how would you make sure even at that time that your data would be accessible to everyone, or your forms can be indirectly interacted with even when at all the times? Third point is the access to the information. Then how do you make sure that it cannot be revoked, right? So here we are proposing a solution which is named as Formsify, under which we are giving each form their own digital identity in the form of smart contract, and that smart contract is getting stored on chain. So thereby we solve those problems of integrity, transparency and accessibility. How do we actually solve them? So let's have a discussion about it. The first one is integrity, right? Now since all our data is decentralized and stored on chain, there isn't a single point of failure, right? And the data cannot get compromised. And since the forms are platform independent, we are just providing an interface, and that interface can be rebuilt by anyone even if we go down. And the system isn't controlled by any single entity, right? Therefore there is no single point of failure, or until the majority of network is not getting compromised, your data, your forms, they are all secured. Second point is the transparency factor. Now all your data is immutable because we store them on chain, right? Therefore your forms will remain unbiased and no one can fill forms on behalf of others until and unless, you know, the respondent's wallet is getting compromised. Third point is the accessibility factor. Now since all the data is getting stored on chain, it is always accessible even if we go down. Suppose that tomorrow we decide to run away, still you would be able to access your data, you would still be able to interact with your forms because they are stored as separate smart contracts and they are not dependent on each other. And your access to information, it cannot be revoked by us because it is stored on chain, right? Now let's go back to the home page, right? And what are the extra features which we are providing? Like the first one is that it is capture free, right? Now since each form submit, it is backed by some amount of gas, if the spammer would eventually run out of them, and it would be very expensive for them, or we can say the forms would become infeasible to spam. Second one is self-reliance, right? You do not need us to interact with your forms. They are stored on chain, they have their own digital identity. We are just providing an interface, and even if we decide to run away, you can still access them without us. Third one is the immutability factor. Like once your forms go on chain, even you cannot alter them and even we cannot alter them, right? So let me show you a quick demo of the product. Here is the dashboard. We can choose any type of form. Let's just create a blank form, right? From here we can change the banner, set the form opening and closing time. We are providing different types of themes by default. We can add a new field from here like this. We can customize it according to our requirements, like setting this to not required, or let's just say it's a checkbox. Let's add some options over here, or delete some options, or you know, delete the field entirely. We can save the draft, and all of this is possible by just connecting our wallet, right? We do not need to sign up or register for anything. We just need to connect our wallet and the data would be stored, right? Let's just see a preview of the form. So like this would how the form would look like when we'll be actually deploying it. The form's deployment address will be appearing over here, like who is the current owner. Now since I have linked my account, so I am the current owner of the form, and whatever the form's deployment ID, it will be up here over here. Let's just go back and let me show you the form which I had previously created. Like this is the Formsify review form. Like let me just view it. And this is the link, like this link you would be giving to people and they would be filling the form, right? So the form is closing in about 90 days, and this is the address, owner ID, and this address, let's just see it on chain. So it will take us to the Polygon Scan Mumbai site, and this was the form which was created before 19 hours, and I had filled the first entry and 16 hours, right? You can actually see that this is the contract address, and the form is actually a smart contract, you know. And let's just say we want to fill one response. So let's say I'm Uday, and this is my response, right? Let's just click on submit button. Okay, it is submitting response. Please wait. Now here there will be a MetaMask transaction which we need to approve, right? Now this MetaMask transaction also adds a accountability factor, because once the form is getting deployed, means your response is getting recorded as on-chain transaction, you cannot deny it, right? Let's just confirm it. Okay, it will take some time to submit the response, depending on how much the traffic is or how long our transaction takes in order to get mined, right? So let's just wait till then. Okay, the response has been submitted. So now we can just go back to our view page dashboard and see what the responses are. So now what's happening currently is it is going to contact on chain, and it is going to see all the data which is stored on the smart contract, and then it will fetch us all the data, right? So these are the legends, like name, suggestions, recommendations, and third one was comments. And here we can see there were two responses, right? This one was I had filled yesterday, and this I currently filled now, August 19. We are converting the block timestamps to local timestamp, so the user can see, like, according to local time when the form was getting filled, right? Okay, and this is my response, right? Now if we can go back to the address, right, now you can see this is the third transaction. Before there were two transactions, like 59 seconds ago. Yeah, so that's how we are creating better forms which are decentralized, trustless, and distributed, right? Thank you.